Toronto, the big city, alive, aggressive, dynamic. The hub of Eastern Canada, a city on the move. People flock here from all over the world, some drawn by the glitter of gold, some by the magnetic pull of life in the fast lane. Quiet little Newfoundland, on the far eastern rim of this country. The prettiest place in the world, but there are few job opportunities, and now the fishery is failing. Our people, too, are leaving for the big cities. But they certainly don't lose their identity or forget their heritage.
You're not giving no hot tongs tonight. I bring them especially for Scott tonight.
Well, Bob don't need one because he got enough tongue.
No, most Newfoundlanders are not swallowed up by the big city. They stick together, and invariably, thoughts turn toward home. And so do appetites.
Can I help you? Yes. Salt pork?
And some hard bread.
Hard bread?
Salt pork and hard bread, uncommon foods elsewhere in this country, but staples for Newfoundlanders. Cod tongues are always popular here, so is salt beef and other Newfoundland specialties. Parrot Store is now owned and operated by Alex, Phyllis, and June Burton.
You're brothers and sisters, I believe.
Yes, we are.
And where are you from, Alex?
We're from Lassie, White Bay, favorite legend. In fact, that's our little community up there.
Yeah. So this is a new venture for you.
A new venture, yeah. Yeah. We took over in July last year. But being here in stores like being in Newfoundland, so they don't miss Newfoundland as much, right?
You'll find this passionate attachment to the old island wherever you go in Toronto, especially among those who've been there a while and yearn for their roots. But what about the newcomers? Norman Stagg just arrived from Cape Friels.
The first time you had a job here in Toronto, was it?
First time I've had a job here in Toronto. First time I've actually seen Toronto.
Yeah, I see. Have you been here long enough to get an idea of what it's going to be like yet?
Not really. I've only been here 3 weeks, and I've been working two out of the three, so I haven't seen much of it yet. And I've been out around a little bit.
What about the work? Is it a big change from back home?
Yeah, I'm working much shorter hours than what I was working when I was home. I'm just working a 40-hour work week. Home, it works anywhere from 10 and a half to 12 hours a day.
And what about the fishermen now? Do they, the ones you know who've come up here, have they had any trouble finding work, or do they like it up here?
No, most people have their jobs before they came up. They know somebody up here, they go work for them. They come up and go right on work.
And that's how Tony Blake of Spiritview landed his job. He was fishing last summer and would be there today if there'd been any fish to catch. Tony loves Newfoundland and his life on the water, but he has to make a living. He has to support his family. His move to Toronto was born of desperation.
Well, Tony, you had a pretty bad year in Newfoundland last year, I believe.
Yeah, really bad. Yeah, we never done nothing with it in the world back home summer.
So bad you had to pack up and come to Ontario?
Yeah, I had to. I didn't have a choice when you come up this way.
Sold your boat and everything, did you?
Yeah, sold a boat and trap. Sold my trap and boat, motor, sold it all. Just get my gionics, that's all, in case I happen to go back something to work.
So you're not 100% sure, and you might be back in the fishing boat again sometime?
I might be back, and I don't know for sure until next September comes. And then I'll know what I'm going to do.
So you're going to give this a good try?
I'm going to give it a good try.
Here's Tony's wife, Sandra, and their three children, Nolan, Natalie, and Neelan.
Sandra, you're here in Ontario, and after leaving Straitsview, was it a good move, do you think?
For the time being, I think, yeah.
Everybody happy?
Everybody's happy for now.
I guess it's great to keep the family together, too.
Oh, yes. Last year, Tony came over for 10 weeks, and we stayed at home, which was difficult. So the year he had to make the move again, so we all moved.
You said if he's going this time, you're going to go, too?
Yeah.
And you're here for how long, do you think?
We're here for a year. For now, and see what happens within a year. Things go good, we could be here longer. But
was it a big boom for the youngsters?
Yeah. Do you adjust good?
No, I didn't.
You like Newfoundland, do you?
Yeah.
What do you miss most up here?
Fishing.
You don't get out and boat here.
No.
So that's what you miss, the boats and the water, is it? Yeah.
Back home in Newfoundland, Nolan practically lived on the water with his father. Little wonder, he's still a bit homesick. The man driving this police car would know all about it, for he too was from a Newfoundland outport. He too loves boats and the sea. Ron Young of Twillingate has been a cop here in Toronto for 20 years. And even after all that time, Newfoundland still calls to him. So much so that he launched a newspaper for homesick Newfoundlanders a few years ago. The Downhomer, he called it. Articles, columns, stories, letters, poems about Newfoundland and Newfoundlanders. The Downhomer was an immediate hit.
It's now starting to be the force which is bringing together all Newfoundlanders. What we try to do is bring in as many communities as we can in the paper. Even if it's just a short news item, we at least mention the name, because people love to see the name of their own town. You know, that makes them feel good about it, you know.
The Downhomer struck a responsive chord in uprooted Newfoundlanders. Everyone volunteered to pitch in. Soon there were people writing columns and soliciting advertising. Even the design and typesetting were eventually done by two young businessmen with Newfoundland connections. One of them is Jerry Clark.
We read through it and we, you know, contacted the people, got to know them, then started to show them the capabilities that we had using the computers to do it. Then approached them about doing the design work for them.
So it was partly a business venture, but partly your interest in Newfoundland roots.
That's right. It is. We are interested, although it's a customer. We do go out of the way, you know, to make sure it comes out properly and have a special interest in it.
What's your connection? Your grandparents from Newfoundland?
Yes, my grandparents are from Heart's Desire, Heart's Delight, that area of Newfoundland. And my father's relatives, aunts, uncles, cousins, still reside there now.
Computer specialist Paul Oldford, the other half of this dynamic duo, is also a contributing writer.
I write a story in there every month called Personality Profile, where I interview various people who've achieved some measure of success here in Toronto or in Ontario, and basically it just grew from there. So it's been fun.
Yeah, I see. So there's a business connection and also a personal one.
A personal connection as well, yeah. Because basically I write the story for Ron every month, and as well Jerry and his team at Corton Design basically do the typesetting for the paper. So.
And of course, being a Newfoundlander, it's a good contact for you too.
For sure.
With other Newfoundlanders and with
for
back
sure.
home.
Yeah, I meet a lot of Newfoundlanders, and I've met a lot actually through the paper. And it's been fantastic because you never know, you know, where all these Newfoundlanders are, and then, you know, they all sort of start coming out of the woodwork. And just being associated with the paper has been good for me. It's been good for my business, and it's kept me in touch with what's going on back home.
And so, once a month here in Toronto, a newspaper called The Downhomer is created. It's a lot of work for a lot of people, but for most of those involved, it's a labor of love. An outlet for homesick Newfoundlanders, a means of knitting together the Newfoundland community, now scattered all over the country. Here comes Bruce Roberts. He writes a column in the Downhomer and is the associate editor. Today, though, Bruce carries a far simpler title, Delivery Boy.
How you doing?
Well, I'm fine, Bruce. How are you?
The Downhomer's here.
Oh,
how are
you doing, Bruce?
Good.
Better in the weather, are you?
Oh, yes.
Oh, we have to do
it. Look at that one, yeah.
Yes.
Very colorful.
The Downhomer people knew that distribution could be a problem. While there are lots of Newfoundlanders in this part of the country, they're scattered about, and there was certainly no mailing list available. How to find them? Well, Newfoundland stores like Parrot's are obvious outlets, and the proprietors always delighted to get the paper. About 500 a month are sold in this store alone. But if the store turns into a library every now and then, the owners don't seem to care. In fact, the Burtons used to hang around here themselves not so long ago. And if they hadn't been avid readers of the Downhomer back then, they wouldn't be in business today.
Actually, when we were buying the store, well, that's where we saw the ad in the first place, in the Downhomer.
Really?
I picked it up one lunch hour I was out, and I glanced through it, and I saw the ad. So he was in the neighborhood, and he phoned me at work, and he said, "Where's that Newfie store?" And I said, "Oh, by the way, would you know, this thing is up for sale. Why don't you check into it?" So when he came over, he asked Mr. Parrott about it, and we got in touch with the real estate, and that's how it all came about.
Yeah. The fact is that we've made a joke out of it. I came in here to buy a pack of our bread and bought a store.
You spent a bit more than you thought.
I did more than you thought.
The Downhomer. It spread quickly. 40,000 copies now fan out to Newfoundlanders all over the country. But it's still an intimate, family-style, down-home paper. For instance, the delivery boy we just met, Bruce Roberts, also writes a column.
We do everything, us in the Downhomer, we actually get involved in everything, or at least we have to date. We've sold advertising, looked for distributors, and got involved in distributing ourselves. We've gone through the whole gamut of being editors right to in the evening, then we take the garbage out, so we do it all.
And you deliver the papers too?
Sometimes. We deliver the papers as well, yeah. And the seed of an idea way back then has really germinated, and now I'm into the passion of my life, if you will. Yes.
And that's the spirit that's kept this little paper going. When we come back, we'll go fishing with the editor of the Downhomer. In the summer, Downhomer editor Ron Young and his wife Sandra returned to Twillingate, where they were born and raised. They bought a house nearby in Merritts Harbor on New World Island. This is their retreat, their escape from the pressures of the city, their way of keeping in touch with family and friends, and of rediscovering an easier pace of life.
Lovely place you picked out to live in, Ron.
Do you like it here, Dave?
Oh, it's beautiful.
Yeah, a little left. It's a vast change from Toronto.
For sure. Must be one of the quietest places, even in Newfoundland.
Well, they'd roll up the sidewalks here if they had sidewalks, for sure.
Yeah. But now you must meet a lot of people you knew years ago when you come back.
Yes, probably, but most of them are like me. They're back here visiting, you know.
Yeah.
I run into people that are. Probably live close to me in Toronto, and I don't even see them there.
Yeah.
Fred Card, he's been around there for a long time.
Oh, yeah.
How you doing, Fred?
Not too bad.
Lovely day?
Wonderful,
sir.
Beautiful day.
Yes, sir. Weather always like that here?
No. Lots of times we get rain. Yes, times the wind.
By the way, Fred's son works for Chum in Toronto. He's in the same business you guys are in.
Same business.
Yeah. Oh, yes. Yeah.
Oh, yes. You ever go up that way yourself,
I've
sir?
I've been up there 3 winters, me and my wife.
I see.
He stays with our sons. And
yeah.
That's a good time.
A lot of Newfoundlanders up that way.
Oh, there is, yes. I got 4 sons up there.
In Toronto?
In Toronto, yeah.
That's why people.
Four boys from this family alone. There's been quite an exodus of young Newfoundlanders from this shore.
There's not a lot of young people live here.
Well, it's a far cry from the streets of Toronto.
Yes, sir.
I guess you really look forward to coming back to you, huh?
Yes, bye. Yeah. After a year, this is a pleasant place to be.
Even if there's no fish?
Even if there's no fish. We usually get fish to buy.
Yeah.
Last year, we went out and none of the fishermen were getting anything. We were having all kinds of luck and they were asking us where we got them.
Of course, whoops.
That about it.
If that's a fish, because the spandy. Oh, one monster, look at that. Big enough to keep, Ron?
Well, boy, we'll starve if we don't keep some of these.
Oh.
Well, what?
Want me to take your picture?
No. No sense to see any sense to cut the tongues out of them.
Well, by now it was obvious we had no worries about swamping our boat. But we weren't what you call serious fishermen anyway. It was really just an excuse to be out on the water. Nearby, the real fishermen were taking aboard some fish from their trap. We went over for a look. For Ron, it was a great chance for a photo or two for the Downhomer.
Geez, that ever a good shot.
Out in boat on a fine summer's day, a real tonic for someone who's just spent a year pounding the streets of Toronto. It brought back a flood of memories to Ron and reinforced the conviction that there's a need for Newfoundlanders living abroad to remember and be proud of their culture, their heritage. That's what the Downhomer is all about.
That's bigger than the ones we got. A little, few, couple little
talk, guys. Okay, hand them to me. There you go.
Great shot. That's more like it. Thanks a lot. We'll see you later. Good. Well, that's better. That's better, Ron. That's more like it.
Yes, bye.
Get a feed out of that.
Keep coming back. Like most Newfoundlanders who leave, you got to come back to your roots. I have to come back every year. I need that to keep me going for the rest of the year, to get away from it all, you know.
Yeah. There are a lot of Newfoundlanders up there, aren't there?
There are more than most people realize. We're starting to find that out now from the newspapers, the things we're doing, the number of Newfoundlanders are coming forward. And I mean, there's no doubt in my mind there's as many Newfoundlanders in southern Ontario as there are Newfoundlanders. No doubt in my mind about that. Yeah.
And is it? Does it have the community feel to it, or are they scattered all over the place?
No, they're scattered all over. There is no particular Newfoundland community in Toronto. Now, some people say, oh, the Lakeshore, that's where all the Newfies are. Some people say Cambridge, that's where all the Newfies are. Some people say Brampton, that's where all the Newfies are. But in fact, they're everywhere. I mean, Scarborough, all over, every part. Now, we're learning this because we're putting the newspaper out in all these variety stores, and wherever we put the newspaper out, the newspapers not only go, but we get feedback from someone who lives there, who'll call up with a subscription or call up with a comment or write us a letter from a certain area. So we know the Newfoundlanders are everywhere, every part of southern Ontario. One fellow, he sent in his money for a subscription, and he says, this is for my brother out in British Columbia. He says, I find it cheaper for me to subscribe than to read the paper through every month on the phone. On Bell Telephone is making a fortune off me.
Much later, back home in the big city, Ron Young's trip to Newfoundland is but a memory. His wife, Sandra, comes out to get the mail. The mailbox is never empty these days. Sandra is kept quite busy with letters and subscriptions for the Downhomer. She's the managing editor, a job that keeps her quite busy, while Ron splits his time between police patrol and pounding the typewriter.
Sandra, I guess you get a lot of mail every day. Always as good as that?
Almost as good as this every day. It's getting to be like this every day. Yeah, it started off, you know, a little slow, but now it's picking up. And this was just from today.
And what are these, subscriptions or letters?
These are all subscriptions.
Really?
And there's 31 new subscriptions here today.
So what, plus some renewals?
Plus some renewals, people that are renewing their subscription that have run out. But 31 new ones that I've counted up.
That sounds really good to me. Is it good?
It's good. It's good.
So people are really catching on to the paper, really starting to ask for it.
Yes, they are.
That put them, I said, about 250 subscriptions in the last 2 weeks, new subscriptions in the last 2 weeks.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we're getting subscriptions from all over. We're getting a lot from Newfoundland, which surprised us. We had no intention of going into the Newfoundland market, but it looks like we're in there anyway.
So we've got subscribers from Athens, Greece, England, Venezuela.
Singapore, Hong Kong.
Quite a few places in the States.
I think homesickness is a big factor here. And, of course, the paper is a little bit of home, and we try to make it that way.
Lloyd Johnson, who's recently created this art gallery, has periodic pangs of homesickness, too. Half of the paintings exhibited are of Newfoundland or are by Newfoundland artists. And there's a good reason. The owner is from Wesleyville. Often he reflects on the often traumatic move from Outport to Big City.
in retrospect, I suppose. I look back and I say, have I wasted years? Have I wasted some time by working 15-hour days and, you know, running, working like bejesus, as the fella says, you know? I think I've lost. Yeah, I think I've lost a little bit. I think the young fellows that, if they're going to come here for the next 10 years and work the same way that we did, they're going to lose as well. But lose, not they'll gain dollars, but they're going to lose, I think, a little bit of what Newfoundland, our heritage, if you want, is about.
And so you still miss Newfoundland too in a way,
oh,
don't
yes,
you?
Yes, sure.
They all miss the old island. From artist George Carter, who left Green's Pond a half century ago and still paints sailing ships, to those who are fresh out of the fishing boat, like Tony Blake.
You know, I go down nighttime and sits down. And comes in my mind to go back home, you know. But if I pack up young and go back home, what can I do? I can just sit and draw around and climb. I don't want to go like that.
You'll be tempted next summer, though, if you hear there's a lot of fish coming in.
Yeah, I said that when I left home, you know. I told Mom and Dad, I said, if I comes up here and phones back home, you're getting a lot of fish. Don't tell me that anybody's coming in with loads of fish. I don't want to hear it.
The Downhomer people, brimming with enthusiasm and zeal, have now invaded the airwaves. The Downhome show reaches out to Newfoundlanders away from home. There's no stopping this crowd.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to the Downhome show, the show for Newfoundlanders and for those who would like to be. Here to host the Downhome show today is your man from Newfoundland, Bruce Roberts.
Good evening, everybody, and welcome to the Downhome show. We have Rob on the controls, and we have Sue in for the answering the phone. And my name is Bruce Roberts, and we have Lloyd Johnson here, my co-host. How are you getting on this evening, Lloyd?
Pretty good, me old top. How's yourself?
Oh, pretty good. By the way, we've got an announcement here, Lloyd. Somebody phoned in. Stephen Scott is going down, driving out to Newfoundland next week, and he's looking for a driver. He just got in from the Northwest Territories, and he's damaged his foot, and he's going to buy a car and drive down. And if anybody out there has got a license that would like to drive to Newfoundland with Stephen and help him out, well, there's a free ride for you.
Yeah. Wish I could go myself.
And so we end the story of a newspaper for Newfoundlanders in an ethnic radio booth in downtown Toronto. But that doesn't really matter. Words written, words spoken, words sung. The theme is the same. Newfoundlanders away from home, filled with nostalgia, reaching out, cherishing their heritage, clinging proudly to their roots.
As I stand here tonight by the ocean, my thoughts wander over the sea to that island far out on Atlantic, and the Yonkers that are calling to me.
Struck one. He struck a nice one there.
Well, we're going to meal out of this, Dave.